Thank you. coming to him one day. Ow, meat back. Feels like it could break at any moment.
Overrun with outlaws.
It looks bad, but I think it's...
Thank you.
I could use a good night's sleep. But where?
Nicholas, the cloth merchant.
I'm Nicholas, but if this carries on, I'll be left with trading me own breeches.
I've heard you and other merchants have thief problems.
From royal taxes to highwaymen, it's thieves left and right. You looking for some friends, or do you have some other business with this question?
I'm not a trader. I don't look for profit in every other conversation.
Everyone looks for their own gain in their own way. So, stranger, who are you?
They call me Robin Hood, and I don't like it when ordinary people are harmed.
Well, that's new. May I ask why all the generosity?
Robbing the royal treasury? That is one thing. But robbing the people of Sherwood is another.
I'm inclined to agree.
I too was once robbed of something dear to me. I'm on a road to vengeance. And helping other wrong souls is a part of that road, I suppose.
Let's say I believe you. But there's one more matter. How do you know about the thefts? You don't look like someone who spends their days gossiping.
I don't. But my people have eyes and ears, and they travel this land. I know things and I try to help. In return, I only want the denizens of this realm to know that Robin Hood and his merry men are taking their side.
I will nobly repeat myself. In the end, I've got nothing to lose. So if you want to help, then listen.
That's why I'm here.
For some time now, merchants of all sorts are being attacked and robbed. Sounds like nothing new, except for one detail.
Robbery innovations.
Very funny. It's about the scale of the whole matter. Bandits steal all sorts of things. They hardly ever robbed entire caravans. That's where it's getting strange. Because when you steal whole bolts of cloth or a wagon of wine, there has to be a trace.
I know one monk who would perform the miracle of banishing such an amount of wine overnight.
What a saint that must be. Anyway, an outlaw, thief, or what have you, isn't just going to sell stolen goods at the market in broad daylight. Doesn't work that way.
He'd dangle on the end of a rope soon.
Exactly. The stolen goods must be going somewhere. For God's sake, it's not magic tricks.
Probably not. Are you saying we're looking for a thieves' stash?
That's where more problems arise. Different caravans have been robbed by different groups of bandits.
So I'm not looking for one place.
No idea. None of the robbed merchants know anything. It's not just the goods disappearing, it's also the carts. Everything! No thief was found using or trying to fence any of the stolen things.
Who else got robbed?
Nick, the wine trader. The whole caravan traveling to Nottingham is gone. Luella, who sold silverware and perfumes. Two carts of goods vanished into thin air. And finally, Philberta Goodwine. An antiques dealer from the north had her ancient tomes and other items entirely looted. She was taking them to one of the monasteries.
So the clergy went up in arms about it too. I see. A strange selection of items.
Robin, we are well past feeling irritated. The thieves take what they can get their hands on. Everything disappears, yet there's no sign of these goods finding their way to other markets.
Do you have any idea where to begin the search?
Yes, I do. My caravan was attacked on a crossroad not far from the tavern. Take a look around there. My cart is said to have left it towards Conisbrough, but no one saw it after that.
I'll take a look at that.
Robin, if you ever catch wind, then follow it to the proof of these thefts. It's important that there's no lynching. I want the thieves brought to justice, so that everyone knows they will be punished. So that everyone knows the Kingsmen had to be relieved of their duty by Robin Hood. And I'll see to that. You have my word.
I like that solution. I'll find the proof and bring it back to you. You'll get to resolve this in accordance with the law.
Good business to you.
Well, keg's empty again. The real
don't pull their banters.
King and his hellish taxes! Even at a time like this, if I could with my bare hands, I would...
I've seen people go to the scaffold for more restrained words.
Have at it, God's child. Go, fetch the royals right now and let them do their thing. Hanging the helpless is all they're good for.
Forgive me, my lady. I didn't mean for it to sound that way. I'm no threat. On the contrary, can I help?
You'll pay all my taxes after my father's death.
I'm sorry for the loss in your family. But what do you mean by taxes? How could your father have passed more than once?
I'm not amused, stranger. One tax to the ruler for his loss of labor, a second to the robe at the graveyard for burial, and a third called the dead arms pay.
That one, for what?
For this miserable house and scrap of field, to keep them in the family.
That sounds like too many tragedies in one place. How can I help?
Why do you want to help me?
Let's say I have my quarrels with the king and enjoy doing things that impede him.
You talk like a man I could grow to like. My name's Lori.
Robin Hood. It's a pleasure.
Yes, and now for the specifics. In a nearby warehouse, there is stored silverware that belongs to my family. We sold them one day to make ends meet.
I understand you want me to steal them.
If you can, yes. I see no reason not to pay with the same silver for the same tragedy.
That's a wise approach. I'll be back with your silvers.
Richard.
Roper! Get him!
Family will starve.
How's your day, sir? you doing?
How's your back? Did you fetch some balm from Marion?
Last time I let myself get coated with the stuff, it was like having pitchlet on me skin.
I'll take that as a no.
Not worth a piss medicine like that. With all due respect to Maid Marion, I'd rather walk this off.
Better start walking right now. I've got an entire Sherwood to turn to our side.
Thank you.
Need something?